cockpit to ground.
Go ahead.
We are cleared for start and push. Parking brake set.
Okay, cleared for push start. Please release parking brake.
Parking brakes are released.
Commencing pushback. You can start the engines in sequence.
It will start in the sequence. Holding position, waiting for the visual. Thank you and goodbye.
Goodbye. Thank you and well wishes. And we are starting up A320neo. Having just completed our pushback here in San Jose, California. And gee, I wonder where we might be going. No, we're not going to Alaska. There's really only one other destination left. Alright, engine number one sounds like it is good. Yes, it is indeed. Engine mode back to normal. We can turn off APU bleed. We will set our takeoff flap setting number one, arm our ground spoilers. Master APU off. Taxi lights are going to be coming on as we will beginning to taxi to our departure runway here in San Jose. And we will be departing from runway 30 right. So we'll give ourselves a little bit of thrust. And we're on our way. And welcome. Good afternoon, good morning, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, to part 6, episode 6 of the National Hockey League Cities Tour. And if you saw earlier, we are flying the Alaska Airlines A320neo, which means we are going to one destination and one destination only with a National Hockey League team. As of this previous October, we are heading to the home of the Seattle Kraken, Seattle, Washington. Here in episode 6 of the National Hockey League Cities Tour. When I first started this thing, it was in the middle of summer and the Kraken hadn't even existed yet. Now they do exist, and well, other expansion teams have had better luck. We'll just leave it at that. Specifically looking at Vegas. Anyways, we will get all of this stuff going. We need to make our cabin announcements.
Flight attendants, please prepare for takeoff.
Takeoff configuration is confirmed. Everything is looking good. As we depart from San Jose on our way to Seattle, one thing that is extremely unorthodox from my point of view anyways is that this departure, we are going to take off, do a 180 and head south, after which we will do another 180 and head back north. I thought something must have been completely goofed up with something, but this is a legitimate departure out of San Jose. And without looking it up, I can basically presume that this is because of the absolute congestion of airports in the California, San Francisco Bay Area, the San Francisco International, There's Oakland International across the bay. Here we are at San Jose, just down the other way. To the south of San Francisco, there's gotta be just an absolute boatload of air traffic. And the best way to regulate some more northerly departures out of San Jose is to just turn them around for a little bit, climb, get some altitude, which is exactly what we will be doing. And then you can continue on with your departure to the north. So we'll get all of our takeoff lights on. That's all good, all good there, that looks good. Double check over there, everything is right where we need it to be. TCAS there. Weather system there. Predictive wind shear is on. I should probably lock my cabin. Maybe I want some uninvited guests while we are in midair. And we are ready to taxi enter to our departure runway 30 right. Before we do a couple of U-turns. Chronometer is set. And we are getting ourselves out of San Jose. Token thrust. One of the more recent additions to the development branch of the fly-by-wire A320neo is that the altitude cap here, see I have it set at 37,000, which will be my cruising altitude, but the caps at the altitude according to the flight plan in the MCDE. Which I thought was a nice touch. So we're gonna get ourselves up to 5,000 and then it'll kind of level us off. We can just on ground spoilers, we got a successful takeoff. Getting ourselves on up 250 IS. And we now move away from San Francisco Bay. Gonna hold us here at 5,000 until we are clear of where we need to go. Forward flaps up. Curious to see what happens when we hit this waypoint, because the the graphical representation of this route is a little bit all over the place. There we go. Okay, yep. And we are going to need to manually get our heading back. No problem. Back towards the San Jose port. Once we hit the VOR, our flight plan should be able to continue on as normal. So it is currently 283. That's probably gonna upward to 300 something. So let's go to 300. Make a huge U-turn back towards our departure airport. 290. It's going to be 315. Nice gradual turnaround. Here's our departure airport right there. Once we hit that SJC waypoint, the San Jose VOR, we're gonna go up to 309. We have a little bit of a wind pushing us to the west. That looks pretty good right there. Over 10,000 feet, so we're gonna bring up our airspeed up to 330. Just departed on this runway right here. A mere 5, almost 6 minutes ago. Now we are over 11,000 feet above it. Well above the traffic heading out of San Francisco and Oakland. This was the whole purpose of that turn around that we did. I'm guessing. Makes sense to me. Alright. We'll be getting ready to reactivate the flight plan in just about 20 seconds. There we go. Back in to nav mode. We can definitely extinguish the nose lights and landing lights and the rain lights. So as you can see, we are heading just barely to the west of due north, and it's going to be a little bit of a zigzag up towards Seattle, and it's not going to be all that long of a flight too. Looks like the overall time in the air it gave me is 2 hours 8 minutes, and we are just about 8 minutes into flight. So depending upon how the descent and landing goes, we should have about 2 hours left to go here. Part 6 of the National Hockey League Cities Tour, heading from San Jose, California, Seattle, Washington, home of the newest team in the NHL, the Seattle Kraken. What a gorgeous look here. Looks like we're heading a little bit more directly over Oakland. We're over Fremont right now. That is Oakland, Oakland Airport. Kind of I suppose the San Jose Sharks are sort of like adequate substitute for being a San Francisco or Oakland. I was about to say it's kind of strange that either San Francisco or Oakland have a national hockey team, but San Jose is going to be back for it. I took that comment back. Sacramento River up this way. This is where the Sacramento River ends up kind of draining in to the San Francisco Bay. Kind of right where Concord, California. Fairfield, California is going to be coming up next, right up here. switch it on over to Mach speed here. Mach 0.80. As we have 10,000 feet left on our climb, heading to flight level 370. 37,000 feet, flight level 370 has been reached, so we are going to disengage from our seatbelt legs. Everybody is free to move around the cabin as they so please for an hour and a half or so before we begin our descent down into the Seattle area, maybe a little bit less than an hour and a half. We'll see. But we will have a short little snack service that will be going out and about in the cabin. And I'm just going to make the call right now. Free drinks from the flight deck. I'd say I'm imposing a 2-drink maximum on the free drinks deal. So I'll be expecting a little bit of a rowdy crowd as we land at Seattle International. But that's okay, because whenever I go to Seattle, rowdy is the way to go. I've been there twice in my life, most recently in 2014, which, thinking about it, does not seem all that long ago to me. Like, I remember my last trip to Seattle quite well back in June of 2014. It's just kind of making me want to go back there, to be completely honest. The first time I went to Seattle was in 2005. So 2005, 2014, I'm due back there in 2023. I think I can manage that. We are at cruise here at flight number 370. Everything's looking good. Flight has been completely uneventful so far. A lot of fields out that way. A little bit of the Pacific Ocean over there. There's some hills.
2,500.
Flight attendants, please prepare for landing.
Runway 16 sector. Just about to say I can't see a goddamn thing. Looks like we cannot. I might not, that's gotta be. There it is, I see it right here. With the clap center right. We have everything where it needs to be. about to connect with our glide slope, heading down to Seattle, Tacoma. And a very gloomy evening in Seattle. Just about to drop our gear once we finally connect, drop our IS down even further down to 140. Got a pretty strong headwind going down. We are on the glide slope. And we are gonna drop that gear. Can't see a damn thing, but we are right in line. This could very well end up being an auto land. Well, 1,002. See some city lights down below. No indication of our field yet. Got some baseball fields down there. Touching 500 feet.
500. 500. 400. 400.
It's finally some runway lights. There we go. 300.
300. 300.
Got a clear view. Autopilot is disengaged.
200. 100. 40. 30. 20. Retard. Retard. Retard.
Beautiful. That's a pretty good landing, nice and smooth. As we exit the runway, we will eventually have to cross over runway 16 left to get to gates, but that we are right where we want to be. Beautiful landing. We're gonna bring all the flaps right on up. We got 16 left. We have been given clearance to cross 16 left. We got a few gates right in front of us here. Looks like we're gonna have to taxi a little bit down towards the south. Turn here. taxi light down. What's a good looking? Let's go right past this US Airways Airbus here. Ooh. No, we're gonna go right past this Amazon Prime. There we go. Yep, I see it. Got it. Locked in just ahead of US Airways. Right past Amazon Prime, you know, lined up. Closing out the flight to Seattle, Washington, home of the Seattle Kraken. Here in episode 6 of the National Hockey League Cities Tour. And where will we go next? I don't know. It'll be up to the random number generator. But I'm glad we were able to get to Seattle somewhat early on, yeah. So you park next to Amazon Prime, and a little FedEx right behind it. We might be in the cargo ramp, but that's okay. Stopped, and parking brake is on, and that'll be it.